Whichit bundled into the yard to find his friend Jam staring at a large wooden box. "What are you doing?" "Hi, Whichit. I found this box and I don't quite know what to do with it yet."
"Boys, there's juice in the kitchen when you're ready. Whichit is here,"
Mum called through the open door into the garden.
"Thanks, Mum. Found him already."
"It's quite a big box." Whichit poked the old wooden box and climbed in.
"Easily fits the two of us. Hop in."
Jams clambered in after him. "Train or race car? Train or race car? Train or race car?" Whichit muttered to the box. Jams groaned. Whichit was called Whichit because of his inability to make a decision. Usually, whoever was there would finally get annoyed and shout, "Which is it?" Which eventually got shortened to Whichit.
"Uh-oh, not letting you make the decision. We haven't got all day. Also, there's no wheels."
"It's a rocket. Let's go to the moon." The boys jumped out and picked up the paintbrushes. "Let's go to work." They painted the rocket red, because red ones go faster, of course. They got some paddles for wings and ran into the house to find some spacesuits.
"Mum, we need spacesuits. Quick, help us find some," said Jams.
Two of Dad's hooded jumpers were dug out and wellies put on. Mum found some cereal boxes to make the oxygen tanks with. She came out to inspect the rocket.
"It's good, but where's the boosters? How are you going to take off?"
Jams and Whichit looked round the garden. Two empty flower pots were put at the end of the craft. It was finished, a masterpiece. Jams hopped in and started pushing the control buttons.
"Get in, Whichit. Get ready to blast off."
Whichit scrambled in. 10, 9, 8.
"Wait," called Mum. "Don't forget your space snacks."
She handed them their water bottles and two bags of crisps. Mum stood back.
7, 6, 5, 4. 3.
Hold on tight. The boys braced for blast off. 2, 1.
Blast off!
The rocket roared slowly into life, lifting the boys up into the air, then gaining pace. Faster and faster they whooshed up into the sky. Soon the earth was far below and they could see the stars.
"The moon's that way, Jams," Whichit pointed,
and Jams moved the joystick to steer the rocket in the right direction. The moon glowed in the distance.
"It takes 4 days to get to the moon, so we should probably relax," said Jams.
Whichit stretched out in the rocket and landed on his crisps with a pop. A crisp piece flew into the fuel tanks and the rocket jerked into life, going faster and faster.
"Are you sure it takes 4 days, Jams?" said Whichit, peering through a window.
"It looks really close."
Jams sat up. "We're here! That crisp must have boosted our fuel."
He landed the rocket by a big crater.
"Spacesuits on!"
Jam zipped up the hoodie and pulled the hood over, tightening the drawstrings. Whichit did the same and they prepared to step out onto the moon. Jams tentatively stepped out of the rocket.
"The surface is soft. It must be the cheese."
"Yes, I hear moon cheese is the best for sandwiches."
"Which cheese is it, Whichit?"
Whichit took a bite.
"It could be yellow. It could be orange."
"Yellow or orange? Yellow or orange?
Oh no, don't get stuck. Here, I'll try it."
Jams took a bite.
"It's that cheese with the holes in, the yellow one."
Suddenly, the ground started to shake.
"Whoa, what's that?"
The moon was vibrating.
"It's coming from over there."
Jams pointed to a crater behind the ship. The boys ran over and peered inside. There were several red and pink creatures in spacesuits with two arms and four legs that wiggled like an octopus.
"Aliens," shrieked Whichit. "What are they doing?"
The aliens had a big drill and were digging up moon cheese pieces. These were lifted onto what looked like space wheelbarrows and floated to their ship.
"They are mining the moon cheese," said Whichit. "But why?"
"Let's ask them," said Jams. Jams and Whichit climbed over the edge of the crater and bounced down to the aliens.
"Hello, aliens. I'm Jams and this is Whichit. Why are you digging up the moon cheese?"
"Hello, funny creatures. How do you manage with so few legs?"
"We're digging up fuel. These cheese rocks power all of our technology. We found this moon has a very good supply. We intend to mine as much as we can and set up a mining base here permanently."
"But this is our moon. If you keep mining it, it'll make the moon shake. It'll make the tides all funny and the night sky look wobbly," said Whichit.
"We need the fuel. We've used up all the moon cheese on our cheese moon. It's our job to travel the universe to find more fuel," said the alien. Well, we must get back to it. The alien turned back to the worksite and the drilling recommenced, wobbling Jams and Whichit over. They bounded back up the crater. With there being very little atmosphere on the moon, Jams and Whichit could make big leaps with each step and they slowly bounced back to their ship, giggling. What are we going to do? We can't let them make the moon all wobbly, said Whichit, bouncing through the ship's hatch. Another tremor came and Whichit stumbled over and landed on the crisp packet he popped earlier with a crunch. Ugh, cheese and onion. Do you remember what the crisps did when it fell into the fuel tank? We raced to the moon in 4 seconds instead of 4 days. What if we gave them some crisps? They wouldn't need to mine the moon cheese, said Jams thoughtfully. Great idea, Jams, but how do we get them to put a crisp in their fuel tank? The boys sat and thought about it for a minute. Their spacesuits are similar to ours. If we add some legs and use face paint, we could pretend to be one of them and sneak the crisps on board. Let's do it! Jams got the face paints and Whichit got some of Jams' parents' socks from the washing line. They stuck them onto their spacesuits and painted each other's faces. Right, let's go. Helmets on. They pulled their strings tight on the spacesuit hoodies and bounced back to the crater. How are we going to sneak down there without them noticing? Said Whichit. Just then, an alien came scuttling round a boulder. Hey, you two, what are you doing here? Get down there and help move the cheese. We need all arms unloading. They followed the alien down to the drilling and picked up a space wheelbarrow and headed for their ship. It was a bright pink triangular shape. They pushed their space barrow up the ramp. Inside was a big grey space full of a mountain of moon rocks. The aliens formed a line of barrows leading up to the mountain and tipped the cheese out in one corner. A team of 3 aliens, not in suits, were weighing the cheese and putting some of it down a chute. Each time a cheese lump went down, a dial got a tiny bit higher, indicating the fuel had topped up slightly. That must be the chute to the fuel tank, whispered Whichit. How are we going to get the crisps in there? I'll create a distraction and you throw a crisp down the chute, said Jams. What are you going to do? You'll see, just be ready to run. Whichit clutched the crisp packet tightly and waited. Jams broke into a run and slammed the trolley hard into the Tower of Moon Cheese. Boom! The nearest alien screeched, no! Everyone turned to look as there was a low rumbling sound inside the mound and the rocks started to tumble down. Cheese slide! Shouted the alien in charge and they started to panic. Aliens were running for the exits as fast as they can, legs wobbling everywhere as the cheese kept falling. Whichit dashed past the aliens near the chute as they stared at the tumbling tower. It started to crumble and come crashing down in a cheese avalanche. Whichit opened his bag of crisps and picked out a small one. Best to go small in case something terrible happens. He shoved it into the chute and ran to join Jams, who was near the ramp with the other aliens, surveying the massive mess of cheese all over the place. Hey, you! You pushed that trolley! The chief alien in the yellow helmet pushed some of the staring aliens out of the way to get to Jams. Whichit, did you do it? Yes, but I only put a little one in just in case. Nothing's happening! The big alien got closer. It needed more. Quick, let's put more in. They elbowed their way through the crowd to the chute to find the operator alien staring at the gauge, which was sliding up the scale, heading from the low red to the top of green. Suddenly, the ship jolted and leapt into the air. Engineers, what is happening? Barked the yellow helmet alien, wobbling about with all the rest.
Sir, it appears the ship is on full power.
What do you mean the ship is on full power? We've hardly loaded any moon cheese. We can explain, said Jams, pulling off his costume. Aliens! Screamed the aliens, now running round madly, slipping over the cheese rocks and slamming into one another. Splat! Silence! The yellow helmet alien shouted and everybody froze. What did you do?
We have discovered that cheese and onion crisps make excellent rocket fuel, Jams explained. We accidentally dropped some in our boosters and we got here in 4 seconds instead of 4 days, chipped in Whichit. We thought that if we gave you an alternative fuel, you would leave the moon alone.
Engineering, said Yellow Helmet, can you confirm what these aliens are saying about the fuel situation?
The engineer had been poking some buttons by the chute. By this time, the fuel gauge was off the scale.
Yes, sir. It appears this crisp is an excellent fuel, 1,000,000 times more effective than moon cheese.
What is this work of genius? Said the engineer, turning to Jams.
If you agree to stop mining the moon and leave our planet alone, I will tell you the secret of the crisps, said Jams. Yellow Helmet thought about it for a second. Sir, this fuel is enough to power our ship home and back 20 times. It could power the planet with only a small amount, said the engineer.
Very well. We will leave once you have given us the secret of this special fuel, said Yellow Helmet.
These are fried slices of potato, said Jams, waving a crisp in the air.
With flavours, said Whichit.
What is a potato? Said the chief scientist who'd just arrived on the scene.
It grows in the ground. We have one in our ship you can have, said Jams.
Excellent. We can use the replicator, said the scientist excitedly.
Oh, you're always using the replicator, said the engineer.
Typical. Can we have the bag you brought with you to take back home?
Yes, Whichit. Stop eating them and hand them over.
Whichit reluctantly handed over his bag of crisps.
I don't like cheese and onion anyway.
The scientist took it with some tweezers at arm's length and disappeared off into the lab. Luckily, Whichit and Jams had potatoes on their ship for space experiments, so they gave the aliens a couple. Then they all said goodbye.
Whichit jumped into their ship.
But Jams, if we've given the aliens the crisps, what are we going to use in our rocket fuel to get home? I don't want to wait 4 days for dinner.
Don't worry, Whichit, we can use my bag of crisps. Jams pulled out his salt and vinegar packet, opened it up and passed Whichit a crisp for the rocket fuel.
Hold tight, said Whichit as he dropped the crisp in and they whooshed off into space. They landed in the back garden just in time for Whichit's dad to come and collect him.
What an adventure, said Jams.
Yes, plenty of tidying up to do, laughed Mum, looking at their pink and red faces in the space landing zone. The aliens never came back to the moon, but can be seen zipping round the universe using their crisps fuel. Jams and Whichit Build a Rocket is a story by Nick Knack. Please feel free to subscribe if you enjoyed this one. Thanks.